this year's Christmas carol service. It has been a strange year with lots of change.
As we prepare for this Christmas, we prepare for the coming of Jesus, our Lord, whose love we can always depend on. His love will never change.
First, let's visit nursery, who have been learning about the special news Mary received from the angel Gabriel.
In the town of Nazareth in the north of Israel, there lived a young woman named Mary. She was just an ordinary girl. She helped her mother to bake the bread and spin the wool and fetch the water just like other girls. When she was old enough, her parents arranged for her to marry Joseph, who was the town carpenter. But then one day something quite extraordinary happened. Mary was busy with the day's jobs, as usual, when she looked up to see a stranger who was standing and watching her. The stranger spoke to her. He said, "Do not be afraid. I am Gabriel, one of God's messengers. I have a message for you from God. God knows all about you and he loves you. He has sent me to tell you that you have been chosen for a very special honour. You are going to have a baby. He will be God's son and you must call him Jesus." Mary did not understand, but the angel continued, "Nothing is impossible for God. Your cousin Elizabeth, who thought she would never have a children, is now expecting a baby." Mary trusted God. "I am God's servant," she said. "I will do whatever he wants."
Not long after this, the Roman Emperor Augustus issued an order that everyone in the Roman Empire must travel to the town he came from, with all of his family, to sign a census. Augustus wanted to make sure that everyone who lived in his country was on a list, so that everyone would pay their taxes. Joseph, Mary's husband, was from Bethlehem. Because King David was one of his ancestors, he had to take Mary on a long journey south, through the hills, and that all they had to travel with was a donkey which carried their food, warm cloaks for the night time, and clothes for their baby, who was due to be born any day.
Mary was very tired when they arrived at last, and there was nowhere for them to stay. Bethlehem was not a large town, and the inn was already full and crowded with travellers. The innkeeper felt sorry for Mary, but the only space he had left was a stable, which he used to keep animals. It was dirty and smelly, but at least Mary could rest.
Baby was born. She wrapped him up as warmly as she could in the clothes she had made and put him in a manger to sleep.
The star in the bright sky, look down and
on the hills around the town. Shepherds kept watch over their sheep. The night was dark and everything was quiet. Suddenly, there was a blaze of light so bright that the shepherds had to shield their eyes. Out of the light, there came a voice, and a man stood in front of them. "Do not be afraid," he said. "I come with good news for you and all the world. The Saviour has come, God's promised King. You will find him in the town, laying in a manger." At that moment, the sky was filled with angels. They sang, "Glory to God in the highest and peace on earth."
At the same time, strangers from a country to the east arrived in Jerusalem. "Tell us where we can find the baby who is to be king of the Jews," they said. "We have been following a new star. We have come to pay him homage." Soon the whole town was talking about the wise man. The Romans, who ruled Jerusalem, had made a man named Herod king of the Jews. He did not want a new king to be born, so he asked for the wise men to come and see him. The wise men told King Herod that the baby was going to be born in Bethlehem. "Go and find him," Herod told them, "and when you do, come back to me so I can go see him as well."
Thank you.
So the strangers came to Bethlehem. They have found the baby in one of the houses with Mary, his mother. Then they opened their bags and gave him the gifts, gold, frankincense and myrrh. God warned the wise men in a dream that Herod was plotting to kill the baby so that he could not grow up to be king. So instead of visiting Herod in Jerusalem, as they had promised, they found another way home.
Thank you very much for joining us for this special broadcast.
We hope that you all have a very happy Christmas.